did some work on genetics and cells, and I hope you will like this idea. It's more microscopic. It's not that big, but we will use a look at specific things. Some years ago, Professor Bart Weitz and Sachs made a difference between what's called customer orientation and selling orientation. And customer means I want to understand the customer and seeking the product. And selling orientation means I want to talk all the time. And we looked at the genetics of these people. Would there be a difference between these two peoples? So why do they behave differently? That's the question we asked. The teacher that I learned not from is Cacioppo. He said, if you want to explain something in social science, use a lower level of analysis, use biology. We have a temperament as a person. So we are born with a genetic basis. And over time, we develop our character. And this is being done by practice. So when you train yourself, you also develop your character. Well, when people develop a character, they develop spines on their neurons. So when you play, practice, work hard, you develop differences in the dendrites. So let's take a look at what happens in life. So when we develop, we have a life trajectory. We are born with genes. We have a temperament. And we train, or we can also become a different person depending on training. We wanted to know, people who are customer oriented, that wanted to understand the customer, why are they different? And we looked at the biomarkers using genetic information, and the problem is that our brain doesn't think like we think in life. The brain just is different. So distinctions like conscious, unconscious, affective, rational, just don't work in biology. It's more complicated.